Monday on Home and Family, actress Shelley Rager shares behind-the-scenes stories from her hit film, Pitch Perfect 2. And from Dancing with the Stars, Emma Slater and Keo Motes have performed for us. That's Monday right here on Home and Family. This is the moment we've all been waiting for. Okay, I am so excited about this segment. All of us here at Home and Family have been glued to The Amazing Race because our very own Laura Pierson, our senior producer, was in it. And when she won with her partner, Tyler Adams, we went absolutely crazy. We were so thrilled and we're so happy and proud of her. So, Phil, I wanted to ask
you. You're still going crazy.
I'm still going crazy. So what was it that you think that made them win this? Because there was a
They're extremely positive with each other.
They
really encouraged each other. I think they saw the best in each other. They celebrated the best in each other. They didn't sort of point fingers. And it made them so compatible as a team and strong because it was all about being positive.
Yeah, and I think today that's really important because there's so much negativity and the reality shows and everything. It was nice to really be behind
somebody. They're like team optimism.
I love that.
You know, I mean, they really were. They were definitely the strongest mentally in terms of just focusing on what was right as opposed to what was wrong.
Okay, well, I'm going to be a little bit shallow here, and they're not too hard to look at. She's beautiful, and he's drop-dead handsome. Okay.
Absolutely.
It's the million-dollar moment right here. Let's take another look at it right now.
Come on over here, guys. Come on over here.
Say it to me, Phil. Say it to me.
No way.
Five continents. Countries more than 35,000 miles. Lauren Tyler, you have won the $1 million, and you are the official winners of The Amazing Race. Congratulations! Yeah. 21 days ago, you guys didn't even know each other. And after 12 legs of the race, here you are.
I love you guys!
I know you wanted to win the $1 million, but you're also looking for love. And what kind of love did you find?
We found love with the world. And we found a lasting friendship.
Yeah.
And we're never going to forget this. This was so incredible. And one thing I did want to say is Laura, she's been awesome. We balance each other out well, and we're here because we were a team and we made it work.
All right, everyone, welcome home the winners of The Amazing Race, Laura Pierson and Tyler Adams. Come on home. That was so great. Congratulations. Oh, my goodness. We did it.
Watch your heels.
Watch yourself, sweetie.
Okay. Watch your heels.
Okay. Oh, my gosh. Laura, you know, we're all sitting here. Please sit. Please sit. Wow. We're all emotional. We all got teary-eyed. But really, what was that moment like for you?
I mean, it was, you can't really put into words that feeling. You go on The Amazing Race hoping that you make it through the first leg. And then to actually be running up at the end with a person that I had met 21 days prior,
right.
It was a remarkable feeling.
It's such a whirlwind, right? I mean, the whole thing goes so fast.
Tyler, for you too, what was that moment like?
Yeah, it was incredible. I mean, it was so neat because we actually drove over the first bridge and we could see the mat and everybody lined up. And then our cab dropped us off. And as we were running, I mean, we knew we were the only team there. And Laura and I looked at each other and it was just like,
we're about to win the Amazing Race.
I started filming her and I was like, do you believe it?
The king of selfies.
No, yeah. We're like, oh my God.
You guys came onto The Amazing Race because obviously you wanted to win the $1 million. You won the $1 million. Every time I asked you guys about the other thing you were meant to be looking for, which was love, you had this ability to just like steer the answer off into a different direction. So here you are, well-rested, well-paid, looking like $1 million.
Yeah, thanks.
And the question is, what about love?
you know, like we said, Phil.
Oh, come on, the world.
Okay, no. Well, look. Now we polled our staff, and 86% of our Facebook viewers chimed in on this, and they all think that you guys are a couple. And we all think you should be a couple. So, are you in denial? Are you really in love, or do you want to keep it a secret? Or what are you going to do? Are you secretly married? What's the thing?
Yes, we are. We're secretly married.
What is going on?
Come here on Home and Family to share.
Oh my God! No.
We're just really good friends. I think that we shared something that we'll never share with anybody else, which has brought us so close as friends. But I think for the love department, we're better as friends.
But why is that? Because this is what the fans really want to understand.
Yeah.
Because they don't really feel like they got the answers from you guys.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, you are so compatible. You're so good with each other. Don't you agree? I mean, you listen to each other.
Yeah.
You were there for each other on this crazy 21-day journey around the world. People are looking at that going, well, if that is not a perfect relationship, then what is it that you two are looking for that you're not seeing in each other?
I think that we found something so much richer and more valuable, which is a great friendship that came out of it. I mean, anyone could go on a reality show and somewhat fall in love, but we came back with a friendship that will last forever, which I actually value more than falling in love, because we could fall right out of love.
Yeah, and if you were together for real, then you two would yell at each other all the time, like couples really do. You know, so
we said that from the beginning, like the fact that we didn't come in with preconceived notions about one another enabled us to be such a strong
so
team.
So open.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you made it very clear what you thought of Tyler when you saw him for the first time.
Yeah, what was the first thing
you said? He's hot.
You said he's hot. And what about you?
Oh, God.
You looked at Laura and what'd you think?
I thought, this girl's got no filter. No.
I don't.
No, I thought she was fantastic and super fit and energetic and like immediately saw that she had a similar attitude towards that I did for, you know, being on the show and getting able to run the race. So it was awesome.
I just want to say, because I'm sorry, I've got so many questions.
No, and you sure you are with them. You know more about
it. I have so many questions because they kept avoiding my questions when we were out there. So I just want to know from you, on the record, you don't have a romantic spark between you. There isn't a romantic spark between the two of you. It's not there.
Okay.
Oh, it's on the record.
It's on the record.
Here's my thing. I think they're actually going to.
I know we've heard that. We've been doing interviews with people like, well, Phil really thinks you guys are together. You're lying to everybody. Well, then just let us be together behind the scenes.
Okay.
Ah,
all right. Okay. Well, since he's trying, he wants to try to find out if you're really together. I want to know what was your lowest moment.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah. Panty pack.
Had to be.
You want to tell a story?
Yeah. Okay. So. We're in Germany, and we got the car, and I'm wearing leather pants and a fanny pack, and like could barely get into the car. So I passed it to Laura in the back, and then I couldn't put the thing in reverse. I had no idea.
No, you couldn't get it out of stalling.
I couldn't figure out how to put it in reverse. So Laura's like, my turn to drive. Fine. So then Laura hopped in the front seat and thought she put it in reverse, but it was in first. And we then ended up on the curb, and in just the haste of getting out of there as fast as possible, I left the fanny pack in the back
seat. Dun, dun, dun. All right, that was a moment. That was
It was dramatic because you can't get to Phil if you don't have your passports, and our passports were in that fanny pack, and we had no idea who had it.
Oh, my gosh.
Yes.
All right, well, we actually have a clip of the fanny pack.
Yes.
Let's take a look at that terrible moment.
Ride your focus in
reverse through a winter wonderland. All right, you want to grab a pen?
Yes.
Yes, I figured out reverse.
Push it.
You got to lift it up.
Yes.
Fanny pack's got pens.
Wait, where's the fanny pack?
It's back there with underneath my bag or something.
No, Tyler, it's not.
What do you mean it's not? Oh, it might be in blue car. So I took it off when I tried to get in the back seat of the car.
Oh, my God.
Hold on. Let's do this challenge. And then what, we sit here and wait? I mean, that's the only thing we can do is wait for that other car to get here.
Okay.
Left it in blue car.
That's not a good moment. Not a good moment.
Not a good
All right,
moment.
We're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, we're going to find out what they've done with the $1 million. I mean, it's not every day you win $1 million, and we're going to find out what they did with it when we come back.